In this video, let us discuss one more natural phenomena based on atmospheric reflection. And this is why the color of sky is blue. See, as we know that red color has the longest wavelength, so that's why it is scattered least. And while the blue color has the shorter wavelength, so that's why it is scattered most. So now, as we know that sunlight has a wide color spectrum, that is, it contains all the seven colors, violet, indigo, blue, green, yellow, orange, red. So, whenever the sunlight enters the earth's atmosphere, the blue color is scattered more and red is least. Because this is defined by the Rayleigh's criteria, which says that the scattering is inversely proportional to the fourth power of wavelength. This means that if your wavelength is more, that is of red, the scattering will be least. This makes the violet and indigo color the sky of color, the color of sky. As also we know that the particles in the atmosphere present are of very small size. As per the rules, the small size particles scatter the blue color and the particles of the bigger size scatter the red color most. So as the size of particles in the atmosphere is very much smaller, this also makes the color of the sky blue. Why not violet? Because we as a human also can't see the purple light, the blue light in clearly. So that's why the indigo and blue makes the sky of blue color. Now, let us discuss another phenomena, that during sunrise and sunset, why the sky or the sun seems to be red or orange. This is again based on this phenomena, as during sunrise and sunset, the sun is at horizon and when we see it, we can see the rays, sun rays has to travel a longer distance. So, while having a longer distance, violet, indigo, blue, green, all these low wavelength colors are scattered away. Only the colors yellow, orange, red has the capability due to longer wavelength to reach our eyes. And this makes the color of sun red or orange during sunrise or sunset. Hope you have understood these two phenomena. Thank you.